for another episode of Buttery Bulgaria. I don't know what alliteration I'm going to use this time, so don't expect me to. With that in mind, dear comrades, we have an interesting show today, right? We finally moved against the Bolsheviks. Or, more seriously, the Soviet Union. We are finally following up the German assaults on Soviet lands. Whose army is that? Is that Moldova? That's a really cool flag. But anyway, so I think it's interesting to point out that we are the fourth most powerful nation in the world. Right? Isn't that crazy? It's just super crazy, man. Who would have ever thought that? That we, sweet little Bulgaria, are the fourth most powerful. Yeah, they would go fourth. Yeah. Anyway, so yes, we have annexed Greece after a long period of time there where we didn't, where it's basically just being occupied. We've conquered multiple regions in Turkey. We've pretty much taken over the majority of Turkey, really. And I keep calling them the Ottoman Empire just because I've been playing so much, like, Making History the Great War and, like, just World War One games lately. That, like, everything to me right now is, that stuff. It's, like, World War One stuff. But anyway, okay, so our army is engaged in Dagestan, and that is no bueno, gentlemen. No, not at all. What do I keep doing? I'm trying to select the army here. Alright, so the second army is engaged. Clearly, we don't have an advantage here, but we actually deal more damage in offense than we do defense. Their defense sucks, so us attacking them is probably... it's kind of iffy. I'm not going to say it's a good idea because, like, we're already starting to take casualties. We're going to pull out. We're going to pull out, ladies and gentlemen. I'm not losing my army over some tiddlywinks bullshit like that. Pull out, men! Ah, brave soldiers all. That's right. Tunguska seceded from the USSR and joined Russia. All right. So much stuff is happening, and I'm, like, completely out of it. So China and the United States are pretty much... they're not at war with Russia, are they? Yeah, they are. Okay. So they are at war with Russia, and they're taking over Russian lands. They're also beating the ever-loving shit out of the Japanese, who still have a very predominant navy in the area. As a matter of fact, it looks like they still pretty much own the waters around their islands, so naval invasion in the region will probably not happen anytime soon. But China is pretty much coming out of this whole situation incredibly powerful, seeing as it is now the fifth most strongest country in the world, and it seems like I'm actually at war with them. That's kind of concerning. This is how you can tell that I literally do not remember what goes on between each level. It's just literally me jumping in and being like, oh, okay, so that's what happened last time. Alright then. Well, anyway. So, on the bright side, we have things. We don't have any manpower. That's literally... the biggest problem that we have been facing the whole game, that we are still facing now, and frankly is kind of ridiculous how much trouble we are having with manpower, especially considering we're a relatively large nation, all things considered. But yeah, we are definitely suffering from various manpower shortages all over our little empire, and it's kind of annoying. Yes. Especially when we got manpower growth of 34. But we're also improving a bunch of collective farms and stuff like that to make sure that we have enough food. Because, yeah, we keep running out of food and we already have manpower problems. So having manpower problems and having, food shortages is just, it's just a recipe for destruction. So we're going to try to avoid that. And we're also going back into Dagestan again. Hopefully we can take this one. Take it this time. Alright, so it looks like we were successful in taking over Dagestan. Okay, we created some more infantry. As you can see, the Russians, I guess they didn't really expect us to come up the rear that roughly. And I mean, we just steamrolled them. Look at that. Like, I think they had like four divisions there, and we just completely rolled them and didn't lose a single thing. So we are definitely making our presence known in the Caucasus region of sweet Mother Russia. And we are supporting our German allies. So hopefully they will continually push in that region to the east and keep pushing east. And hopefully they will draw the majority of the Soviet Union's ire. Because frankly, we cannot take on the Soviets by a lonesome by ourselves. No, sorry. Oh, look, we got some new infantry. We're going to move them right there. All right. Do we have any more infantry anywhere else? Just these cavalry units. But I guess we should probably keep them there to maintain that region. We also need to build more vehicle factories. That's right. Because vehicle factories are going to help us build tanks here soon. Because we got tank prototype 1. So basically, that's what we need to start doing. I guess I'll do auto fretage. I don't know. I'm just kind of throwing stuff out there. Auto fretage. It doesn't matter. We have enough industrial or research capacity that we could pretty much research everything relatively quickly. So I'm not too concerned about it. War industries. Okay. All right. Looking good. I don't really know what to do right here. Should we keep pushing west? I guess so. But then we would leave ourselves exposed. Yeah. Oh, look, see, we can build tanks here. Awesome. We're going to do that. It's going to take 200 turns, but by Jove, we will have tanks in just 199 more turns. I'm just kidding. The industry is going to recover, and then we will actually probably have pretty decent, speeds. Kano State seceded from the United Kingdom. Morocco declared war on France. Nigeria declared war on France. So on and so forth. All right, we're going to move in. We're going to move in and move out. So if we take Stalingrad there, or we can move here into the Volga Delta. Oh, no, we definitely can't take the 691st Army. They are packing some serious heat right there, buddy. Hopefully the Germans will kind of focus on that. And so we don't have to. West Indies, blah, blah, blah. Things happen. All right. So we have a pretty decent army, though, all things considered. We're a little short on arms, which I guess is just because of the length of our actual supply lines is the reason for that. And whoop. Take that land. Take it. Yeah, there we go. Look at that. Look at that, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, sweet Bulgaria. Who would have thought, like seriously, who would have thought that we would have done this much damage with Bulgaria at this point in time, eh? I mean, it's just devastating. Who owns that? Why is it blue like that? Oh, so that's Russia. Not the USSR, that's Russia. So they still have the same unit cards. They just have different... That's misleading. And definitely hard to keep up with, but whatever. Is that all they got there? Oh, no, they have a whole shit ton of guys there. All right, so we got to be careful. All right, but at least we picked up a couple more manpower-producing areas, and we're pretty much sucking all the manpower out of this region. And that's kind of my main purpose for what I'm doing. I'm just trying to get some of this manpower that we need. Oh, so desperately. I wish I could actually move over here and take that, too. Tengen's. But I can't hold it. Until the Germans push forward a bit more, we just don't have enough infantry support to do anything about that. Do they have any more guys there? No, just the ones. You know, we could actually probably attack them and do relatively successfully. Let's do that. Alanya. We'll bring in our new infantry squads as well. And I'm going to put this in the Mamara Sea there so that it can basically... It'll be an easy transportation unit. You can get men here and there, everywhere. Alright, move those up. Supplies needed. We still need more manpower. I don't think I'm ever going to have enough manpower. Oh, damn, the Russians pushed back. I should have known. Well, that sucks. No big deal. No big deal. Infantry 28th, production infrastructure Novorossiya. 3. Yep. Okay. Alright, so lots of stuff just happened. Thankfully, our army is far more effective offensively than the Russian forces in Kuban. So, if they decide to actually move against us, we could arguably beat their ass. How long is it going to take on that tank? 24 turns? Well, that's just not fine. That's just fine, but it's really not. That's not fine at all. Is this all we can get? This is all we're crunching out? Well, let's get some militia pumped out. Oh, God, everything costs manpower. Everything! I can't have a break here. I just want stuff to not cost manpower. All right, so we're going to move. Move against them. Conquer more of the Ottoman Empire's land. Show them that we, dear viewer, are not to be trifled with because we are bad sons of bitches. Actually, let's cancel that order. Yeah, cancel your order. I don't know what you're doing. Move here. And can you load onto that ship? Or can you just... No. Okay, you got to load onto the ship. It would have been nice if it could have been like, all right, well, since there's a transport there, you can just move right across. Move along, gentlemen, move along. And we're going to bring in that cavalry over there. We're going to go ahead and send that over just a little bit. See, that's... God, I just cannot get over these crippling manpower issues we're having. It's literally stopping us from accomplishing anything. Like, anything, very essentially successful is because of that. So it's kind of lame. Oh, look at that. We got attacked. The Battle of Camellia. We're running out of arms, but damn it if we aren't a formidable force of total ass fuckery. That's right. We need more regions, though. 722nd. It's not going to be 18 turns on those early tanks. Sure would be nice to get them a bit faster, don't you think? Yes. And we're going to defend that region right there, because I guess if we move here, we can easily move to the east, we can easily move to the west. Should be a relatively good thing to do. And we're going to move these fellows up as well. We're going to move these fellows up as well. And we're going to move these fellows up as well. End our turn. See what happens. Oh, looks like the Turks landed in Tarsus. Unfortunately for them, my army is much... much bigger. That's right. Okay, things happened. No one cares. Alright, so, we still have the Russians moving into the Caucasus there. We're winning that, though, so I'm not too concerned about it. So, is the Blue Russians on my side? Are they on my side? Yes, we're not at war with them. Okay, so that means I don't have to worry about these armies, I think. Yeah, I guess so. I guess they're all... I don't know. What are they? No. Those are these... Okay, those are USSR. All right. It would have been really nice if they would have actually changed the flag so I could really tell the difference between these guys. Because right now, it's just... I cannot fucking tell the difference between either group. So, anyway. All right, so move in. These additional infantrymen. To assist our brothers fighting in Tarsus. And you, gentlemen, are going to merge together into one singular force. You're going to load onto the first fleet, and you're going to move on. Okay. And how much longer on these collective farms? These sure are taking a while. I'm pretty sure that's where a lot of my manpower's going. It's into those things, and the infantry I keep building. Don't you attack me with logic, video game. Nonsensical stuff. Alright, Algeria was founded. Algeria declared war on France. Okay. Unload the 18th. Unload the 27th. So we have more troops into the fray. How's the war going on here? It's going. That one field artillery is actually putting up a pretty formidable fight. Blackhead. And that's owned by the British. We are at war with them, so we could probably take those back. With the additional unit reinforcements we have coming in, we're actually pretty much a devastating threat to the Turkish forces. I wish the Turks would take peace, though. Like, surrender. No. Surrender your occupied territory. No, they were just... Yeah, see, they're not taking my shit. Which is a shame for them, but... To each his own, I suppose. 613. All right, so our army up there should be fine. It should be able to hold these regions. Probably going to lose Kamilkia there, but I don't really care. The main army is going to hold off. The second army there is going to hold off the Russian attack forces that are coming in from here, which is fine with me. It looks like the Russian army has actually been defeated, too. Or the Navy, my bad. The Navy has been defeated. So, we could drop some forces over here, like in Kuban. But I don't know how effective that would be, so I don't know if I'm going to risk it. Anyway, load onto the first fleet. Move up, boys. Continually move up. War is ours. Sweet bloody victory will be ours. And you know, it's been 500 turns. Like, I've been playing this for 500 turns. It's crazy. It's just absolutely insane. Alright, can close farms, collective farms, resource improvements, and tasks, take one damage, whatever. Don't really care. Alright, so we need to take this region from the Ottomans. They're starting to bring in reinforcements, and holy shit, their army's actually pretty big. Okay. No bueno! But we will manage. We always do. I think what I'm going to have to do, though, is I'm going to have to wait for them to kind of attack first. To put the first foot forward, as it were. And we will go from there. It looks like the Russians actually attacked our main army. And it did not kill anything. Of course not. It was stupid to attack us in the first place. We have a gigantic army, you fools. Whatever. Send your men into the slaughter. I don't care. Even though I do care, because that manpower, I'm really hurting for it right now. But, you know, I don't know. Wink, wink. Anyway, this has been Commissar Bro. Thanks so much for watching this video. I know it's a little bit longer than my usuals. So I hope you guys are okay with that. I'm sure you are. A lot of people generally ask me to do longer videos anyway. But that's aside the point. That was nice. But anyway, this has been Commissar Bro. And I will see all you amazing comrades next time.